Okay. What are the strategies implemented by the government for tribal women, especially who needs skill development, mental health, and awareness, ma'am? And how are they reachable to them? Please, thank you.
Come on. Thank you for letting me answer this question. He actually stated and sent that the 106 question is, what is the strategy adopted by the government in the making of tribal women to get skill development, mental health awareness, and how come the government make them
sir,
equally participate
sir,
in governance?
Do you have an answer for it?
No, ma'am. This doesn't take.
Sir, please have a seat.
Madam Speaker, hum kaam mein believe karte. So now I will start with an example. Now this is about a startup. Mind you, we keep a good track of our startups. About Siri Gramodyoga in Karnataka. Grama Prasadyoga, Siri Gramodyoga in Karnataka, which promotes rural women empowerment and it facilitates vocational training among them and it facilitates employment opportunities for them. It provides, another is that NSTFDC, that is National Scheduled Tribes Finance and Development Corporation, which was set up in 2001. It also implements Adivasi Mahila Sashaktikaran Yojana, which provides a loan of up to 90% of project costing up to rupees 2 lakh is provided at a concessional rate of interest 4% per annum. Here I have shared two examples in our country from different places which are a good example of strategies that are adopted by us to help these tribal women gain skill development, mental health awareness and help them participate in governance of our country. Thank you.
Honorable Madam Speaker, my name is Tejas. I am from I am Deputy Minister of Tribal Affairs Ministry. Today I am going to answer the question asked by my fellow opposition member. Tribal women can achieve skill development, mental health awareness and equal participation through dedicated government program, as my honorable Prime Minister said. For example, our government has launched a tribal empowerment program which provides training and resources fostering greater inclusion and support, which is already implemented in the states like Assam, Tripura, etc. I hope this answers your question.
Honorable Speaker, Madam, with your permission, as a put forward request, I would like to ask a supplementary question to the Minister of Tribal Affairs.
Yes, sir.
Ma'am, please. You have stated that about various schemes which has been set by your Prime Minister, right? So, sir, I'm asking that you haven't heard my question clearly. I was said that, like, how it is implemented? Like, how it is... See, let us take an example of Tawang region in Arunachal Pradesh. So, in Tawang, it is very difficult for you to reach... You to reach the town, and there are many places in northeast. So how would you make them to reach over there? That's my question. Please answer my question, ma'am. Honorable ma'am, with your permission, the Prime Minister even haven't answered my question yet. Ma'am, she was just saying about the schemes, but not about the implementation. How they are implemented? We want implementation. Please.
Yes, Mr. Sparsh.
Honorable Speaker, Madam, I, Sparsh, the Deputy Prime Minister, who would like to answer to Honorable LOP's answer question by stating the Ministry of Tourism has collaborated with the Ministry of Civil Aviation under the RCS Udaan scheme. As of date, 53 tourism routes have been operationalized and to improve air connectivity to tourist destinations. Now this is related to giving employment opportunities to tribal women, as out of these 53 tourism routes, a lot of them are present in Arunachal Pradesh, and along with that, Ministry of Tourism is also running a Pan India Incredible India Tourist Facilitator IITF certification program, a digital initiative that aims at creating an online learning platform with the objective of creating a pool of well-trained and professional tourist facilitators. So even if we are not physically going there, we can train them online through this initiative. So I hope that answers your question.